In this class, we are going to discuss about JK flip-flop. So, as we know about SR flip-flop, it's having four states. That four states are no change state and set and reset and indeterminate state. There we are having four states. In that four states, one state is going to waste. So, if we want that state or not, that can be a problem. So, for example, if you don't want that indeterminate state, we just want only set and reset. For that, we design D flip-flop. For example, if you consider D flip-flop, only set and reset conditions are possible. If you take in SR flip-flops with set and reset, you have a no change condition, but if you take an SR flip-flop, one condition is going to waste, one time cycle for S equal to SR equal to 1 cycle is going to waste. So, in that case, to change that indeterminate state, to use that indeterminate state, we are having another circuit. So, that indeterminate state we are changing like toggle state. In that particular condition of SR is equivalent to 1 1, so that state, that circuit will provide 1 1. So, same SR flip-flop, we are making a small change to work as JK flip-flop. The main use of that JK flip-flop is we are toggling the inputs. That means, whatever indeterminate condition in SR flip-flop, indeterminate state is there, that state we are using here, and we are changing that indeterminate state to toggle state. That means whatever SR is there, the toggle of that SR will come. That means here we are naming that SR as JK. So now, just you know that this is structure for SR flip-flop. The only change we make for this to become like JK flip-flop is we change it like this. So, we given this connection here also. Previously in SR flip-flop, we are not having these two connections. Without these two connections and inputs are as S and R, this is nothing but a SR flip-flop. So, to make use of that indeterminate condition, we are designing this JK flip-flop. So, in that indeterminate condition, we will get toggle state now. So, here we will see, we taken just this feedback to this previous gates also. So, now I am propagating the inputs. So, as usual, your present state you don't know. The required output for any sequential circuit is your next state only. So, next state means Qn plus 1. So, this you need to determine. So, here you don't know your present state. So, that's why you can take don't care at the present state value. So, here your JK inputs may be anything like 0, 0, 0, 1 and 1, 0 and 1, 1. So, you don't know your present state at any value. So, that's why I am just taking don't care. The present state may be either 0 or 1. For that don't care present state, you need to take next state. So, now I am taking this first condition. So, I am just taking this first condition, J is equal to K equal to 0, J equal to 0 and K is equal to 0. This condition I am considering. Always clock must be is equivalent to 1 here. So, here I am just considering J equal to 0 and K equal to 0, clock is equivalent to 1. Now, see here, 0 into anything, other two inputs is equivalent to, so 1 here. So, 0 into 1 whole bar, you are getting 1 here. So, 0 into anything whole bar, you will get 1 here. Now, you are crossing this 1 with this Qn bar. So, what you are getting at Qn plus 1 after crossing these present states, what you are getting is Qn plus 1 only. So, here your Qn plus 1, that means your output is equivalent to, so 1 into your Qn bar whole bar. I am just crossing this gate. So, now this is equivalent to Qn. Whatever already is there, you got same thing by crossing these inputs to inside. So, that is Qn plus 1 is equivalent to Qn. So, you don't know this Qn value, that's why to guess this Qn value, I am going for complement port. That means I am processing this gate. If you got any value here, no need to go for complement port. Here you didn't got any value up to now. So that's why I am going for complement port, that is Qn plus 1 bar. This is equivalent to, I am just processing this gate. So 1 into Qn whole bar, you are getting Qn bar. So you can observe whatever present state outputs are there, same you got like for next state also. That means no change. So whatever Qn plus 1, Qn is there, same coming in the place of Qn plus 1. You can observe here. Why we derived this means? To observe, to check whether we are getting any value in complement port or not. When you are not getting value here, that means 0 or 1, you need to check for complement for value. Even here also you are not getting, means you can write as it is. Whatever you got, then you can write as it is. So now I am going for this condition. The second condition is equivalent to J equivalent to 0, K equivalent to 1. So J 0, K is equivalent to 1. Now see here. So 0 into anything whole bar is equivalent to 1. Now see here. So here you are having 1 into clock, another 1 into, so where you are taking this input is coming from Qn. So here your output may be, so from this gate output 1 into Qn whole bar, you are getting Qn bar here. You are getting Qn bar here. So now I am just propagating this gate. So top gate I am propagating Qn plus 1 is equivalent to, so this gate I am propagating 1 into, so Qn bar whole bar, you are getting Qn here. I didn't got any value here. To check whether there is value at complement port, I am going for this gate. So complement port is nothing but this port. So when Qn is there, it will provide Qn bar complement. So when next state output is there, it will provide complement of next state, like that. Qn plus 2 is there, it will provide Qn plus 2 bar, like that. So here to check whether we are getting any value in complement port, so I am checking this Qn plus 1 bar. So to get Qn plus 1 bar, I am just propagating that Qn to Qn bar. So I am having Qn bar here and Qn here, Qn bar into Qn whole bar. So A into A bar equal to 0, 1 into 1 bar equal to 0, like that. Anything and its complement if multiplied will provide 0. So 0 bar it will give you 1. So here you are getting your Qn plus 1 bar is equivalent to 1. Yes, you got value in complement port. This you can use as a reference to get value at normal port. If Qn plus 1 bar equivalent to 1, you can implies that your Qn plus 1 equal to 0. That means your Qn is equivalent to 0. This you can put 0. This is called as reset condition of your JK flip-flop. When JK flip-flop is going to reset means, when J equal to 0, K is equivalent to 1, that is called as reset. So now I am taking my third condition. Third condition is J is equivalent to 1, K is equivalent to 0. So now I am taking J is equivalent to 1 here and K is equivalent to 0 here. If K is equal to 0, without knowing two inputs, this gate will provide 1. And top side, if you can see 1 into 1 into, this is coming from Qn bar. You can observe here 1 into Qn bar whole bar, you are getting Qn here. So if you observe this Qn plus 1, if you are writing for Qn plus 1, so this is equal to, so Qn into, to get Qn plus 1, you need to process this present inputs. So Qn into downside, you are getting Qn bar whole bar. So A into A bar whole bar means like 0 bar only. So this is Qn into Qn bar is 0, bar is equivalent to 1. You already got value, So at Qn plus 1, no need to go for complement port now, because whatever next state is there, you got here only. So to for example, if you want to take your complement of next state, then you are getting 0 only, no need to calculate here. So you got in first step itself. So this is called as set condition. So now you are taking your fourth one. This is called as j equal to 1, k is equal to 1 condition. When j equal to 1 and k equal to 1, what you are getting is, so when j equal to 1, k equal to 1, 1 into 1 into, here Qn bar is there, here you are getting Qn, and here 1 into 1 into, this Qn will come, 1 into Qn whole bar, you are getting Qn bar here. Now see here, so I am just writing like this. So I am writing equation for Qn plus 1. So Qn plus 1 is equivalent to, so here if you want Qn plus 1, you need to process this gate. The gate inputs are Qn and Qn bar. So now I am taking Qn into Qn bar whole bar. So that is meant by, so here Qn into Qn bar whole bar means, so here you are getting some 0 whole bar, you are getting 1. So now here if you processed this gate, if you processed this gate, what you are getting, you just check here. So if you processed this gate, so again Qn into Qn bar will come. So again you are getting same thing, that means, so you are getting, so here also 0 bar will come, that means 1 will come. So how it will goes to toggle condition means, you can check here. So 1 into, when you take in this Qn bar, you are getting Qn, and here 1 into Qn, here you got Qn bar. Now I am just deriving the output of this gate first, and after that I am processing that input to next side. So that means, so you just take this gate, so that means this gate output I am considering, Qn plus 1 whole bar I am taking. So if I want Qn plus 1 whole bar, I need to check these two gates inputs, that means Qn into Qn bar whole bar you are getting, that means 0 bar you are getting 1 here. If you want any Qn plus 1, if you want any Qn plus 1, then Qn into 1 whole bar you are getting Qn bar. So whatever Qn is there, that complement you are getting. So that means you can write like, so this is equivalent to Qn bar. So this is called as toggle condition. So first you just operate this gate, and after that you just take this to input. So that means whatever this gate output is there, that you can consider as output. So here if you take in one, if you got one here, obviously here you are getting 0. If you are getting 0 here, obviously here you are getting 1. Like that you need to propagate.